The State Minister for Information, Godfrey Kabianga, says 11 students are still missing from the Kasese school attack. Residents speculate that they might have been abducted by the rebels.
Who are they? Who are those four bodies? Where must have they come from? And I think the director of the school now should answer, should tell us where he got those children, where he got all the children from, so that we can widen our investigations.
Kabianga also says four remains are unclaimed for because samples could not be matched to the parents.
To call out a DNA and 13 bodies, their DNA matched with that of their parents. However, we are still stuck with the four bodies whose DNA has failed totally to match.
Our reporter visited Kibwe Trading Center about 600 meters away from the school, where rebels looted shops as they retreated to their hideouts in the Democratic Republic of Congo. At this trading center, Grace Busesa, a businesswoman, explains that she saw a group of 30 people in uniform at 9 p.m. headed in the direction of the secondary school.
We are not yet to sleep. I heard some alarm coming from outside. Then I called the nurse. Nurse, I'm hearing what is coming from outside. Then we heard some bullets coming from there.
Busesa says after 30 minutes, she heard the sound of guns from the same direction the group had gone.
I reached to my neighbor. I heard her saying that, Baba, msiniue. For her said that, they said that, Mama, if you were not with that baby, whom would have killed you?
According to Busesa, the strangers came to her door and started to pound. They got into the house and demanded to know where her husband was.
They said that, where is your husband again? I said that I don't have the husband. So you give us your phone. I said that I don't have the phone. There and then I escorted down and saying that you shouldn't kill me.
After she informed them that her husband was not around, they looted her shop. Items worth 2.5 million shillings were taken.
And the 5 kilograms of rice, 150 kilograms of cassava flour, 150 kilograms of sugar. They took 75 kilograms of beans. When I calculated all that things, it amounts to 2.5 million.
Businesses have been struggling to recover following the incident.
Most of the businesses, our community members are acquiring them as a result of getting loans, and it is now a big problem. They can't pay back the loan. They can't continue with the business. They can't support their...
Use it to get all that money in circles, bankers. So up to now, they are demanding their money from me.
Sylvis Mapoze, the LC3 chairperson of Mpondwe Lubiriha Town Council, reported that business at the border customs is yet to recover from the June ADF rebel incident.
Three people reported to have had their commodities stolen by the rebels, and this has affected their livelihoods, and equally from the shops they would pay licenses to the local government. They can't even get what to pay for their children in school because they are tormented, they are affected by what they saw and what they heard these people say.
Report by Gilbert Muhanguzi from Kasese.